Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to enable case insensitive search in AEM with Lucene. By default, the Lucene search is case sensitive. We have seen in one of the earlier videos how to create a Lucene index for search the property data in nodes. I have two nodes with the same property value but in different case. Let me show that in CRXDE. I will go to sample data. Let me take note the 999. So if you see the ID, the value is test. So if I go to node 998, the same ID value is same, but in different case. Is in lowercase and that one is in uppercase. Now let's see how the query is behaving. So let me go and execute this query. If you see the query, it's like the path, and here the keyword I am using the contains, not like. Like won't work for this scenario anyhow. So I am using contains, then ID, then test. Yeah. Now if I execute, it will only give the node 998. It means it's exactly matching the value. So if I go to that, it's exactly matching. But somehow it's not giving caps test. So the search is behaving as a case sensitive. Now the case insensitive can be enabled through analyzers in Lucene index. So let's see what is analyzers. Analysis in Lucene is the process of converting field text into its most fundamental index representation called terms. These terms are used to determine what documents match a query during searching. Means if somebody is searching for a word, so that will be matched against the terms used by this analysis process. An analyzer tokenizes text by performing any number of operations on it, means which could include extracting the words from the field and removing accents from characters, lowercasing, removing common words, reducing words to a root form, or changing words into a basic form. So even you can have multiple other operations on the field. This process is called tokenization, and the chunks of the text full from a stream of text are called tokens. So means like you have a search data or you have a field data. So this tokenization process convert that into chunks of data, those values are called as tokens. So the tokens combined with their associated field name. So let's say my case ID is the field name, then the tokens can be the test data. The data in that field is converted into tokens. My case anyhow, it's only a test is the value. So let's say like a test caps is the value, then that will convert it into lowercase. So that's called token. Token with this field name ID, corresponding tokens are called as terms. Then whenever somebody searching, the data will be matched against this terms. In Lucene, the analyzer is a Java class that implement a specific analysis. Analysis means tokenizer, then some filter also we can see that further. Analysis occurs anytime text needs to be converted into terms. So within Lucene's core are two spots. One is during indexing and when searching. So this operation, the tokenization analysis or tokenization converting into terms, this operation happened in two places, two times I can say. One is during the indexing and another one is whenever we are searching. Okay, an analyzer chain starts with a tokenizer. Tokenizer is the starting point to produce a initial tokens from the characters read from a reader. Like reader, you consider that is the actual data. Then tokenizer token create a tokens out of it based on the what kind of tokenizer you are configuring. Then modifies the tokens with any number of chain token filter. You can associate multiple token filter into the tokenizer to filter the data. So then finally it will create the tokens. Some of the important built-in analyzer in Lucene bundle are white space analyzer, symbol analyzer, stop analyzer, keyword standard analyzer. So this is the some of the important inbuilt analyzer. So this includes the tokenizer, includes the filters, required filters. So based on the operations, this analyzers are provided. So white space analyzer, mainly it will remove the splits the text into tokens on white space. So it will remove the white space. Then symbol analyzer, it will split the token non-letter character at non-letter characters. Then it will lowercases each token. Yeah, those are all the major operations the symbol analyzers analyzer do. Then stop analyzer is same as symbol analyzer, but it will remove the common words also. That is additional functionality of the stop analyzer. Then keyword analyzer treat entire text as a single token, so it won't do any match operation on that. Then the standard analyzer, this is the core analyzer. There's lot of logic in the standard analyzer, so identify certain kind of tokens like company names, email address and host names. It also lowercases each token and remove stop words and punctuation. The built-in analyzer, whatever we discussed now, can be directly used by specifying the class name. I will show that how to do that. Or the analyzers can be composed with the tokenizer and series of filter. We already seen in this diagram, the analyzer is made of combination of tokenizer and multiple token filter. So we can even compose the analyzer in AEM, like with multiple token filter and the corresponding tokenizer. So tokenizer examples are like, there is multiple tokenizer example, standard tokenizer, keyword, character tokenizer, multiple token filters are available, stop filter, lowercase, standard filter. So we can use any combinations. So let's see how to do that now. If I go to this one, so let me go into analyzer. So to define the analyzers, first you need to create indexing, you need to create a folder or unstructured node called analyzers. And under that, to specify a default analyzer, you need to create a default node. This is again no properties, just you need to create it with an unstructured node. So I will explain what is this. This is a kind of composing example. But if you want to use the standard analyzers, so what you can do is in the default node, just to go and add a property called class. So then you need to provide the class name of the analyzer. So here, if you see, this is the class name for standard analyzer, Lucene analysis, then standard or standard. You can just copy that or simple analysis based on your requirement. So just add that and save it. So you don't want this tokenizer filter. These two nodes are not required. This node is required if you are not using the standard analyzer and you are composing your analyzer through this tokenizer and multiple filters. So how many filters you want, you can configure. So otherwise it's a very simple process. You can just tell, you don't want this anything, just add the class name to the default node. So the analyzer, corresponding analyzer will be used. So there are multiple standard analyzer, tokenizer and token filters. Also you can create custom analyzer, tokenizer or token filters based on your requirement. Let us see now how to configure the analyzer to support the case insensitive search. Okay, now let me show how to do that. So as I already told, I am not going to use this standard analyzer. Again, the standard analyzer itself will do the lowercase conversion. But anyway, I am not doing that. I am going with the composing that with the filter. So if you want, you can just configure the standard analyzer and use it. Otherwise, you can follow this composition. So now for that, under default, you create a node called tokenizer. So just you need to specify name, standard tokenizer should be enough. But if you have any other requirement, you want to have a different tokenizer, you can use that. Or you can have a custom tokenizer also. Now under default, I created a node called filters. So it's again an unstructured node. Nothing configured. Now I want to implement the lowercase filter. So for that, I'm going and creating a node again, create node. A lowercase, okay, just save it. Yeah, now fine. Now we are saying like apply the filter lowercase to the data, and it will tokenize. So during the indexing, So the data in the node will be converted into lowercase and stored to the indexing. Also, whenever we try to search it, so same logic will be applied. So when you execute the query for a particular, let's say lowercase value, so the value, the uppercase nodes also will be matched. So yeah, that's fine. Now I created a node with name lowercase. Now we need to, let me save it. Now we need to reindex it. So I'm going and reindexing this. Fine, maybe you refresh it. Yeah, it reindex. Now let me go back and here execute. Yeah, if you see here, now both the nodes are coming. So if I go to this node 999, so go to the property. If you see here, it's a caps test. And this one, 998, if you go, is a small test. So is the test became a case insensitive. So uppercase or lowercase, the data is returned. Okay, I will be sharing this index definition, and you can see the URL in the description. Yeah, thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.